Hello everyone, this is Dr. Shashi Meena, Assistant Professor from Department of Geology, University of Rajasthan, Jaipur. I am here to present the topic Impact of Pesticides on Wildlife and Human Health. As we know that pesticides are widely used in agriculture, public health and household pest management to regulate pest population. That could increase agriculture production and prevent disease outbreaks. But injudicious use of pesticides consequently has made them an integral part of biological, geological and chemical cycle of the earth. Majority of the pesticides are appearing in the nature and increasing their concentration in the food chain and having acute and chronic poisoning to the environment and wildlife. Pesticides residues get into the food chain which disturb the functioning of the food web of entire community by breaking off subsisting dietary association between the species. So, what are pesticides? Pesticides are chemical substances which kill the pest population by their toxicity. They are used to manage the insect pest population, microbes, vertebrates, weeds and other harmful organisms which damage crop, vectors of diseases, rice nuisance and harmful for the human property. Pesticide residues are crucial indicator of the environmental pollution and represent the ability hazard to environment and wildlife. Their accumulation of the pesticide is crucial component that have an effect on survival and sustainability of the viable population. More than 3,000 pesticides formulations are used worldwide. A pesticide is a combination of the active ingredient which shows toxicity and inert ingredient which is additive. And their classification is based on their mode of entry, their mode of action inside the pest body and chemical composition and target species against which they are used, such as insecticides, rodenticides, acaricides, avicides, fungicides, herbicides, etc. On the basis of chemical composition, pesticides are grouped into inorganic pesticides, organic pesticides, fumigants and biological pesticides. Inorganic pesticides are those chemical substances which contain toxic elements such as arsenic, copper, lead, and mercury. Organic pesticides are generally synthesized chemicals, but some are natural toxins obtained from the plants and mainly constituted by carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen, such as natural organic oil, animal origin insecticides, plant origin insecticides. Synthetic organic compounds are mainly synthesized into laboratory and these are chlorinated hydrocarbons, DDT, SCH, methoxychlor, etc. Cyclodines such as chlorodine, aldrin, dialdrin, etc. Carbamates such as carbidyl, carbofurin, etc. Organophosphates as ester of phosphoric acid such as dichlorvas, malathion, monocrotophos, etc. Synthetic pyrethroids which are analog of the pyrethrum such as alethrin, permethrin, cypermethrin, deltamethrin, etc. Fumigants are gaseous or vapor chemical substances such as aluminium phosphide, carbon tetrachloride and hydrogen cyanide, etc. Biological pesticides are eco-friendly formulations of the biological agent in the form of parasites, parasitoids, predators and microbes such as Bt, NPV and insect hormones. Miscellaneous compounds such as neonicotinoids, spinosins, avermectins are some other examples of the pesticides. On the basis of mode of entry, pesticides are categorized into stomach poison, contact poison and fumigants. Stomach poisons are pesticides which are applied to the food and when ingested, absorb within the digestive tract and kill the pest, such as arsenicals, Paris green, melatonin, etc. Contact poisons are chemicals which kill the pest by means of contact or through entry into the body by the vulnerable sites of the body surface, such as synthetic pyrethroids. Fumigants are the toxicants which enter into the body through respiratory pores and kill the pest by the action of the vapor as a respiratory poison. Aluminium phosphide, carbon tetrachloride and chloropicrin are some example of the fumigants. On the basis of mode of action, pesticides are grouped into physical poison, protoplasmic poison, respiratory poison and nerve poison. Physical poison are chemicals which exert physical effect on the insect body, such as abrasion of the cuticle, a loss of moisture and blocking of the respiratory pores. For example, activated clay, natural oils, aluminium oxides are such physical poisons. Protoplasmic poisons, which ingested chemicals and accountable for the precipitation of the protein of the epithelium of the midgut. This mechanism is also known as arsenolysis because arsenicals are the main chemical insecticide which cause such type of the impact on the midgut. Respiratory poisons are compounds along with air enter in the respiratory system and interfere with the cellular respiration by inhibiting respiratory enzyme activity. Nerve poisons, which are chemicals that interfere with the functioning of the nervous system, such as axonic poison and synaptic poison, which include cyclodines, synthetic pyrethroids, organophosphate and carbamates. On the basis of era of the development, pesticides which were introduced before the discovery of the DDT are known as first generation pesticides, such as inorganic pesticides and plant products. Second generation pesticides are those chemical substances which were introduced after the discovery of the DDT in 1939, such as organochlorines, organophosphates and carbamates. Third generation pesticides are those chemicals which were introduced after the ban of DDT in 1965. They were more eco-safe and alternatives of the toxic chemical substances and mainly include juvenile hormones and insect growth regulators. Pesticides and toxicity. Toxicity of the pesticides mainly depend on toxic substance, their dose and the length of the exposure time. Toxicity is measured in LD50 and LC50 values. This represent the 50% mortality of the test animal and calculated in the form of milligram per kg and ppm values. Toxic effect of the chemical may be physiological, biological and biochemical and pathological in the nature. And by their action, they may be narcotics, corrosive and irritants. And the action of the chemical can be classified as locally and systematically. Locally, by editing the tissue with which they come in contact with action, may be severe and cause tissue destruction. Systematically, by being absorbed into the bloodstream and carried by it to the site of action. Distribution and deposition of the pesticide. It is a dynamic process and transformation of chemical pesticides as well as their destiny in various cubicles of the environment. Pesticides have different route of distribution and persistent pattern inside the surrounding, such as in air, water and soil. Distribution and deposition of the pesticides in the environment, such as in water body, take place through the drainage, leaching, surface runoff, discharge, domestic, urbanization and industrial effluents. In air, this process takes place through spray drift, emission, aerosol and volatilization of the treated surface. In soil, deposition on soil and vegetation blown across the field and landscapes. This flowchart showing pesticide transport in the ecosystem. Pesticides from their sources such as disposal, dumps and application on crops, agriculture fields and transported to the components of the ecosystem such as water bodies, soils, lands and finally they reach in the body of the humans and wildlife through the ingestion of the contaminated food. Exposure of pesticides to wildlife. This process takes place through different routes such as can come into contact to pesticide-treated vegetation and soil, consumption of pesticide, contaminated vegetation, water and animal prey, to feed on pesticide-treated insect bait or granular insecticides, direct spraying of the solid and liquid formulation of the pesticide, using of sedimentation and contact to other organisms that live within the sediment. Exposure of pesticides to wildlife. In aquatic system, aquatic predators or organisms accumulate the pesticides contained in their prey as well as directly from the water. In terrestrial system, predator-prey associationship is seen in which terrestrial animals are greater infected than their prey species due to prey selection via the predator. In human body, exposure of the pesticides take place through direct contact, exposure through contaminated food, water and air. This picture showing the distribution of the pesticides in different environmental compartments through various mechanisms such as volatilization, infiltration, deposition, evaporation, sedimentation, etc. Pesticide toxicity has its impact on wildlife through different mechanisms such as acute toxicity, chronic toxicity, indirect effect and secondary poisoning. Acute toxicity is the immediate effect of the pesticides. It is a direct exposure of the formulated concentration of the pesticides on animal through ingestion, inhalation or dermal contact to kill or sicken the flora and fauna. Chronic toxicity, this is a delayed effect of the pesticide. Exposure of the wildlife over a prolonged time period to pesticide group not at once kill but may additionally bring about continuing poisoning. For example, physiological, reproductive and behavioral changes in the animals are seen after chronic toxicity. Indirect effect. This is the additional impact of wildlife in a roundabout way when parts of its habitat or food supply is changed, such as depletion of pollinators, natural animals and non-target animals, etc. Secondary poisoning. This is a predatory-prey association in which predators consuming contaminated prey often result in mortality. Since the toxic dose ingested by the predatory birds and vertebrates affect through biomagnification of the pesticides. Impact of pesticides on environment. Distribution and deposition of the pesticides in the environment change or alter the conditions of the environment and directly or indirectly affect the wildlife population of the nature. For example, many factors affect the environment such as contamination of the soil, hydrological system, pesticides accumulation in food and water, a potential inflow of the pesticides into the surroundings. Impact of pesticides on environment. Pesticides has their impact on nutrient cycling, soil and water. Insecticides reach into the soil, constructing tractates and the nutrients getting back into the vegetation. Effect on soil organisms, indirectly interfering with the nitrogen fixation. Pesticides interrupt nutrient cycle in the atmosphere and cause decline in soil fertility and soil productiveness. Impact on soil. The pesticides alter soil properties. Pesticides affect the growth, functional structure, diversity and biomass of the microorganism of the soil. Affect mineralization of the soil organic matter. And they also disturb the metabolism and alter soil enzymatic activity. Effect on water. Pesticides contaminated water bodies, make disruption of the aquatic ecosystems, which hazards consequences on human health, aquatic organisms. They also hampering in fish culture in water bodies. Organization of the wildlife. Wildlife means the wild undomesticated animals living in natural habitats. Ecologists include both animals as well as plant species into the wildlife. Impact of pesticides on wildlife. First of all, we will take birds which are strongly affected by the pesticides application. Direct exposure to pesticide spray, ingestion of pesticides, granules and treated seeds and crops, contaminated water or feeding or contaminated prey and baits cause birds mortality. Carbamates, organophosphates, organochlorines cause altering bird feeding behavior and reproduction, nervous system toxicity and higher mortality in the birds. DDT and its metabolite DDE affect courtship behavior, delayed in mating and egg laying and decrease in egg weight. Aerochlor also cause egg shell thinning in the bird. Bird species are also exposed to their skin and eyes and they ingest chemical residues when they preen their feathers and inhale a small droplet and pesticides vapor over treated fields. Overall, sub-lethal effects of the pesticides in the form of endocrine disruption, teratogenic effects, alteration in feeding behavior, and compromised immune system affect the avian reproduction. Impact of pesticides on amphibian. A well-known herbicide, glyphosate, affects non-target amphibian jeweline crop. Atrazine, another herbicide, cause 10% adult male frog transform into the female due to missing testosterone and resulted into reduced fertility rate. Khyansi spray toad, which is the rarest amphibian species of the Tanzania, is near to extinction due to the pesticide application in the environment. Pesticides influence indirectly amphibian population by hampering growth of aquatic organisms population such as phytoplanktons, zooplanktons and fungi as they represent one of their major energy source. Impact of pesticides is also seen on mammals. For example, 58 species of the British mammal population such as hedgehog, water voles, common pygmy, shrew found decline by 66% due to pesticide application pressure in the natural field. Predators are also affected by ingesting contaminated prey and direct application of the insecticides. For example, cypermethrin and imidacloprid cause higher mortality of the predators. Pesticides can influence the behavior of the predator and their life cycle parameters such as the developmental period and their longevity, growth rate and other reproductive behavior. Behavior pattern and survivability of spiders and ground beetles is influenced by pesticides and indirectly affect biological control in an agrosystem. Pollinators are greatly affected by the pesticide application in the nature. Pollinators are biotic agents such as bees, fruit flies, beetles, birds. Pesticide application affect various activity of the pollinator such as the pollen collecting behavior, mortality of colony members and foraging behavior. Foraging behavior and longevity in honeybees affected by sublethal concentration of imidacloprid. Exposure of neonicotinoid insecticide cause homing failure. Insecticides have high impact on learning and memory skill and foraging behavior of the bees. Natural enemies and beneficial organisms are greatly affected by organochlorines, organophosphorus and carbamates, thus upsetting the natural ecological balance. Effect on non-target animals. For example, DDT caused mortality to spot fish. Phenytoin and aminocarb highly toxic to all arthropods and non-target insect and spiders, including many predators of the birdworm. Phosphimiodone caused relatively little damage to the birds. habitat change, decrease in the availability of food because the outbreak. Impact of pesticides cause loss of keystone species in the food chain. As a consequence of pesticide application and their deposition in the nature, keystone species are being badly affected and can have far-reaching and unpredictable effects. The hammering of keystone species may result in a series of cascading effects such as modifying trophic dynamics, bonding in food web, and can be reason of extinction of other species. Wild plants are also badly affected by use of herbicides. Herbicide directly linked to the decline or hammering of wild plants, and they also affect non-target plant species and other animal species. They cause disease and reduce seed quality. Herbicides harm other useful plant species and remove wild floral species, which indirectly becoming a reason of scarcity of vital food sources. Pesticides application has an indirect impact on wildlife in the form of development of the resistance. Resistance is a development of ability to a tolerant dose of insecticide, which would prove lethal to majority of the individuals of the same species. For example, carbamates and organophosphates, insecticides are main causing factor insecticide development in the many animal species. Another impact of the pesticide application is the secondary pest outbreak. Application of pesticide against a major pest kills and natural enemies of minor or secondary pest. This cause outbreak of the secondary pest. For example, use of synthetic pyrethroids against bollworm in cotton killed natural enemies of the whitefly, causing an outbreak of whitefly, which was a minor pest till then. Another example is the outbreak of predator diamond back moth, a major pest of the cabbage. And another impact of pesticide application in the form of pest resurgence. This is a rapid reappearance of a pest population in injurious number following pesticide application. This is due to killing of natural enemies of the pest, cause pest increase. After initial decline, resistant population increase in large number, elimination of primary pest, increase in feeding and reproductive rates of insect pest. For example, quinine phosphate cause resurgence of BPH in rice, and carbofurin cause leaf folder in rice. Cotton bollworm Helicoverpa arbigera is another example. Impact of pesticides on human health. According to WHO, more than 30 lakhs cases of pesticides poisoning and 2.1 lakh deaths are reported worldwide each year. The human population may be exposed to pesticide either on account of occupational exposure, intentional consumption, or accidental exposure. Pesticides can penetrate the human body through breathing of the dust, vapor, and aerosol that contain pesticide by consuming contaminated food and water and through dermal exposure by direct contact of pesticides with skin. These symptoms are categorized into two groups: acute effects such as headache, body ache, skin irritability, poor concentration, diarrhea, vomiting, nausea, tremor, spasms, anxiety, seizure, dizziness, impaired vision, stomach cramp, etc. Chronic effect such as cancer, birth defect, and growth disorder, diabetes, allergy, teratogenic effects, endocrine disruption, reproductive toxicity, etc. These are some common health effects due to specific pesticide exposure. For example, respiratory disease due to aluminium, cancer induced due to DDT and DDE and PCBs, lung cancer due to chlorpyrifos and cobalt, prostate cancer due to organochlorine pesticides, disturbance pregnancy hormones due to organochlorine pesticides, and other women health problems due to synthetic pyrethroids and organophosphate, a specific sickness due to organophosphorus pesticides, irritations due to contact of the pesticides with the skin, eye, or different mucosa. This table showing the average dietary intake of pesticide residues in milligram per day per person in various countries. In USA, it is 7.6, in UK, it is 12, in Canada, it is 13.3, in Australia, it is 20, in Germany, it is 149, in Europe, it is 156, in India, for non-vegetarian, it is 356, and for vegetarian, it is 362. Thus, we can observe from the table that average dietary intake of pesticides is very high in India than other countries. This table showing the pesticide impact on human health, including the headings, insecticides, their exposure, toxicodynamics, symptoms, such as organophosphorus, carbamates, organochlorines, triazines, pyrethrins and pyrethroids, phenoxy derivatives, glycine derivatives, and dithiocarbamates. Conclusion. Pesticides have benefited all around the world by raising agriculture yield and controlling disease outbreaks. But long-term toxicity and hazard issue associated with pesticides to human health and wildlife and environment has moved up concern the safety from pesticides. If the condition is continued, impact of pesticides on wildlife directly or indirectly will affect the biodiversity of flora and fauna and measure unrepairable outcome on the environment. With no delay, the environmental pollution and a subtle deflation of the ecosystem caused by irreparable use of pesticides should be reduced as insignificant. Ultimately, the service that support the environment should be promoted and bring into practices such as reduce use of pesticides and pursue alteration of the pesticides with diverse mode of action. Certain hazardous pesticides should be banned. Consider the selection of the pesticides and modification of operational practices. Application of pesticide should be under trained worker. Limit the aerial spraying. Enhancement of mechanical and cultural practices in the agriculture. Pesticide registration norm should be revised, and finally promote the use of botanical and biological alternative of the pesticides. So this is all about the pesticides and their impact on wildlife and the environment, and I'm sure that this content will upgrade your knowledge. Thank you.